Hey everybody, this is Brian, and welcome to the 94th Qt tutorial with C++ and GUI programming. Wow, 94 tutorials, we're really cruising along here. Alright, today we are going to learn how to write XML. So let's just make a new project here, put it in the usual place. Next, next, finish, finish. Now, first thing we want to do here is actually go into our project file, and we want to add an include for XML. Once you got that done, you're ready to go. So let's jump into our main.cpp and let's add a few includes here. I'm going to add Qt Core, even though we have a Qt Core application, which means we can get rid of that. We'll add all of Qt XML, and then of course we're going to add the infamous Qt debug. Now our application right now doesn't really do a whole lot. Let's give it a good build, make sure we got everything linked correctly. So doesn't really do anything. We've just got our basic generic console application, which we've seen a million times. And we are going to get this to write some XML, so we're just going to put in a comment here. XML can get a little bit tricky when you're coding it, especially when you're coding it by hand, because you tend to lose track of where you are. So let's say Q document object model document. That's what the QDOM stands for, is Q document object model, and we're making a document. Now we have our document, but we haven't done anything with it yet. So what we need to do are create elements. So we'll say Q DOM element. Whoops, don't need an element primate, we just need an element. And we're going to call this root, because this is our root element. If you remember from our XML primary, a well-formed document will have a single root node. We'll say document, and we'll say create. Oops. We want create element. Let's just go ahead and hide our window here. There we go. That way we get more space here. Now that is our root element. Whoops, helps if we put our little equal sign in here. Just because we have a root element doesn't mean it actually exists anywhere. So what we need to do is actually append it. Say document, append child, and we're just going to add the root element in there. And that will also append any child elements. If you remember from our primer, we can add a node within a node within a node, or I should say an element within an element within an element. So we can add multiple children to this root. So let's just say, make the root element, and then we're just gonna document here, add it to the document. And don't worry, we're not gonna document every single line here. Just want it to be perfectly clear what we're doing here. Now let's write out some code really quickly to write this to a file. And we're just going to say qfile. Let's give this a file name here. And let's just call this myxml.xml. If you're wondering what this code does, you should really watch the tutorial we've done on file IO. Basically, we're just opening a file and we're saying the QIO device, and we want to get the write-only access to that file. And we're going to do it, of course, in text mode. That's not working. Sorry, I've had a long couple days. There's some wood siding on my house. My house is half wood, half vinyl, and me and the better half, or management as I like to call her, decided to go out there and replace some of that. And what started as a very simple job, as I'm sure some of you homeowners are out there snickering, what started as a very simple 2-hour project ended up taking 3 days. I failed to open file for writing. Basically, we're just doing a very simple test here to see if, in fact, we could open the file and write to it. And if we couldn't, we're just going to return an error code. We'll just say -1. And if we could, let's just say else. Say Q text stream. Now I had a viewer, sorry, I've actually been doing some writing on the side. I had a viewer write in and say, hey, why don't you have some of this stuff already pre-written so we don't have to sit here and watch you type? Well, that's a very, very good question. I've asked myself that many, many times. And the only answer I can come up with is, if it's pre-written, I tend to skip right over it and not explain it. So if somebody had not watched this tutorial or any of the previous tutorials on how to stream something to a document, they'd be going, what are you doing? And it would just, it wouldn't make any sense. It wouldn't have any real congruence. So just for the sake of argument, bear with me as I whip this code out real quick. I can't believe I just said whip this out real quick. Anyways, you guys know what I mean. Quit snickering. All right, so let's just say Qdebug, and we're just going to say finished. So really, let's do a quick review here. All we're doing is we're creating a Q document model document, or QDOM document. We're creating a Q document object element, or QDOM element. And we're doing that through the document.create element. It does that because, well, documents can have specific schemas and things that we really won't touch into because we're not going to get too deep into how XML is structured. But what that does is the QDOM document is it actually makes sure it's well structured versus the document, and it gets all the formatting in there. And now that we have our element, we will say document append child, and we're going to append that element. Now we're going to put extra elements in here and they'll all get appended. And then we're simply going to write out to a file. Now notice these forward slashes, that is the cross-platform way of doing it, because if you do it that way, that's an escape character and that's a no-no. So let's save and run, and else without previous if. What did we goof up here, guys? Let me pause this real quick and find the error. Yeah, that one threw me off for a minute. It's because I got this right there. All right, let's run this real quick, see what happens. And it says, ta-da, finished. Let me pull that up real quick. All right, now there's not a lot to our XML file, as you can see here. Basically, we've just got our declaration followed by an empty element here. So we're gonna populate this out a little bit more. Let's bring up Qt again, sorry about that. Now, if you remember from our discussion earlier, what we're talking about is we have this root element, and that is what we've appended here. So what we need to do here, I made eye contact with my cat, here she comes. Hey kitty, daddy's recording. Go bye-bye, love you. I don't know what it is with this cat, but I am like invisible to her until I start recording something, then she's got to have my attention. We're going to add some elements here, and we're just going to say, kitty, go bye-bye, daddy's recording. See, I hate to have the cat whining in the background, but this far into it, I just hate stopping and starting over just because the cat's whining. So I hope you guys like cats, and I hope none of you have dogs that absolutely hate cats, because she's going to sit here and whine for my attention for a few minutes. Yes, kitty, I can't type and pet you at the same time. Go bye-bye. See, the problem is I made eye contact with her, and because of that, I'm sunk. All right, so we're going to make an element here, and we're going to call it node. And we're going to say, this is document.create element. Kitty, why don't you go take a nice nap or go watch the chipmunk cuts outside? And we're just going to call this book, because, I mean, we're just going to make an XML file that has a bunch of books in it. Now, we have our node. What we need to do here is we're going to set attribute. Remember our discussion of what an attribute is. We're going to give it a name attribute. And we're going to say the name of this is my book, and let's give it a number here. QString number. If you're wondering what I'm doing, that's how you convert a QString into a number. Or I should say a number into a QString. Sorry about that. So we're just going to convert I, our current index, into a number. So it's the name attribute is quite literally going to be my book and space and then a number. And then we are going to say ID set attribute, and we'll just say ID, you know, we'll say it was like an ISBN number or something, but we're gonna take the cheap and easy way out, and we're just gonna give it the index here. All right. Now what we want to do here is say root.appendChild, and we want to add the node in there. And actually, you know what? Let's not call this node. Let's call this book. All right. Save our work. Run this. Says finished. Let me pull up the file. And sure enough, here's our new XML file. You see we've got the same declaration. We have our books element, and we can collapse and expand that back out. And in here, we have a bunch of book elements. Now what we're going to do is we're going to take these individual book elements and add chapters to each book. So we've got 10 books. Let's just go ahead and add like 10 chapters per book. Jump back into the code here. And we can pretty much just copy and paste this code here. Pretty simple, pretty easy. And we're just going to say chapter. And we're just going to set the name to my chapter, and the ID is going to be the same here. Let's set these actually to H instead of I, because we're in our inner loop here. It's a nested for loop, in case you're fairly new to C++. Save our work, run this. It says finished, no error so far. Give it a quick refresh. Now you can see we've got our root element, and inside our root element we have individual books, or I should say individual elements, and each element has other elements. And you can keep going and going and going and going. That's the beautiful thing about XML, is that you can structure it the way you want it. So no two XML files are identical. That's actually held pretty true in my experience, is that XML is so flexible that, well, it sometimes can be a nightmare to deal with, which we will discuss in our next video, reading XML. This is Brian. I wanted to thank you for watching this tutorial, and if you get a chance, if you haven't been there before, some shameless advertising here, head out to my website. I've got all these tutorials out there. You can just go under Qt. I've got other languages, and I've got them all in order. I am working on the playlist for YouTube. I know you guys love those. And let's say you go into a tutorial here. You can watch the tutorial, and you can download the associated source code with it, so you don't have to retype all this garbage. But anyways, this is Brian. Thank you for watching. I appreciate your feedback. I know I'm like really, really sorry. I've been horrible about getting back to you guys. Life has just been crazy. Like I said, I had my VMware test, my cat, which oddly has disappeared. So let's talk very quietly so she doesn't hear us. Anyways, my cat's been bugging me and working on my house and work and the kids. So I will get to your messages, I promise you. Let me repeat that. Uh-oh. Here comes the cat. See, I spoke up. I will get to your messages. I'm sorry. It's just going to take me a little bit longer. So if you're sitting there going, Brian, why haven't you returned my message? I'm getting to it. Anyways, thanks for watching. See you next time.